You're overwhelmed with the fact that you loved us. You died on the cross for us. You shed your blood for us, Lord Jesus. Jesus, you are Lord God and Savior. You're the God of eternity, the God of creation that came down and through the womb of a woman, and you lived a sinless life. You did many, many millions of miracles, signs, wonders, and miracles. You showed yourself to be righteous. And without fault or guilt, you preached and taught the things of the kingdom of God. You taught about the glory and the nature of the Heavenly Father. You called men back to you. And in the fullness of time, when there was no animal and no human, no angel you could find to pay the price, you suffered and you died for the sins of me and the world. I am so glad, Jesus. And so today, as we come into the knowledge of who you are and all your person, we declare that Jesus Christ is the one and true living God, the resurrected God. We don't say it out of ignorance, but your Bible teaches that you are Jesus. You are God of creation. We don't only talk from the Bible. History tells us that you are Lord, that you lived, that you existed, that you did many miracles, signs, and wonders throughout the years because of your holy church, because of your people and your love. You've built hospitals and schools and provided water and hope, and the gospel of the kingdom is still being preached around the world. We not only recognize that you are Lord because of the Bible and because of history and other scientific reports, we know that Jesus, you are Lord and God, just like you said in this Bible, because we have a personal encounter with you. Every day we experience you and your love and your concern for us, your care, your provision, your protection. We hear your voice. We feel your presence. We know you are always with us and always near. And in spite of what we have done, you've loved us and cleansed us and washed us. You've encouraged us on. Jesus, with my own eyes, I serve you because I've seen the sick healed. And the oppressed men and women who were ready to commit suicide turn around. I've seen your heart turn men and women around. Not only have I seen it, but I've seen demonic spirits, invisible beings, just like the Bible says, come out of human beings by your name. Many times I know that you have power over Satan and demons. You have power over life and death. You've had visitations in this house, and we've had visitations from you many times as we worship and praise you, as we did deliverance. Jesus, our minds and our hearts are fixed now and for eternity that you are Lord. You are the living God, and you're coming back for your people just like you said. So, Lord Jesus, we pray today that you seal our fate, that you help our unbelief, that, Lord Jesus, you said, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. There's no other name in heaven or earth whereby man can be saved. Today, we receive the name of Jesus as our salvation. We receive the blood of Jesus as our salvation. And we pray for those who are listening and watching will make Jesus Christ Lord. They will give everything in this world that hinders them. Because, Lord, there's no riches, no wealth, no prosperity, no education, no career, nothing in this life that compares to life in Jesus Christ. Not only what we do for Jesus Christ in this lifetime and with this body will last. Everything else will fade away. So we pray for those who are making a decision, that they say a prayer and say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart, save me. I live for you. I give up everything for you. right now in Jesus' name. Bless this house. Bless this time. I speak blessings of the Lord Jesus upon everyone listening and watching today. In Jesus' name. Amen. If this message has been